Okay, so there's an interesting report circulating that Emma Watson has come under fire from internet trolls, in inverted commas, over her tribute to the late Alan Rickman. A quick word about Alan Rickman from myself. Undoubtedly, he was one of Britain's great actors, greatest ever actors. I mean, I always remember him as a great character actor. I always remember as Sheriff of Nottingham in Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, best Sheriff of Nottingham in any adaptation, in my opinion. Severus Snape, of course, everyone knows that role. I never watched the Die Hard series, so I can't speak about that. Barchester Chronicles was a British TV series about him as a clergyman. That's probably better known to British audiences, but a very prolific actor. And yeah, it's certainly a coincidence that he's died at the age of 69 of cancer in the same week as David Bowie has died at 69 of cancer. So that's sad news, of course. Emma Watson, of course, played Hermione Granger in the Harry Potter series, so she obviously knew him very well. I think it's fair to say they were friends. And like Daniel Radcliffe and the other cast members, she's paid her tributes. But it is what she has chosen to use as a tribute that's attracted controversy. We'll speak a little bit about this and explain why I'm on the fence with this one, because I do see both sides. So basically, she put a quote from Alan Rickman from March of last year, in which she said, "There's nothing wrong with a man being a feminist. I think it is mutually beneficial or to our mutual advantage." So in other words, it's Alan Rickman describing why he's a feminist, or stating that he is a feminist. I must admit that's something I didn't know. It wasn't like I wasn't familiar with that aspect. I don't think it's such a big thing. There's other male celebrities who are, I believe Benedict Cumberbatch, and there's a few others. That's that. Now, what people accuse her of is exploiting this to push her own feminist agenda. I think that's sort of half true. The first thing that we have to recognize, and I'm saying this as someone who's very critical of third wave feminism, I don't call myself a feminist and I'm very critical of it. However, I will to some extent defend Emma Watson. Why? Because a quote is a quote. So if that was his position, and I see nothing to suggest this is an inaccurate quote, that's what he was. He if he described himself as a feminist, that's what he was. Now, obviously, Emma Watson has become a very high profile feminist ever since that UN speech, so she is making the tribute to him through her through his own quote. So in a sense, it's sort of like shooting the messenger. On the other hand, given that she is a high-profile feminist, I think it would be naive to suggest that there isn't some motivation here for promoting feminism. There clearly is. I mean, first and foremost, it is a tribute to her friend, but the fact that she is such a high-profile feminist, you can't ignore that those two things going together. I think some of the comments were uncalled for. They were a bit harsh. They're accusing her of being disgusting and exploiting it and so on. I don't think that's quite true, because it's not like she was a total stranger. They were friends, so she knew him better than anyone who was commenting there. Having said that, I do think feminists will use every opportunity to promote feminism. I think it will come into every piece of dialogue they come out with, because there is no doubt that there is an agenda there. But it's an agenda that Alan Rickman would probably have endorsed. So I'm sort of on the fence with this one. Let me know your thoughts. Was she right to make the quote? Do you think that she was only, it's a case of shooting the messenger? Or do you think her quote was inappropriate? Or not her quote, sorry. Do you think that, making a link to that quote was inappropriate? And do you think she was pushing an agenda? I think it's a bit of both. I think if he said it, that's what he said. So she's, can't shoot the messenger. On the other hand, she is a well-known feminist, so it figures that she's going to want to promote feminism at every opportunity, and it looks like that's what she's doing. I mean, you know, I guess from her point of view, it's a case of, well, my friend believed in this. This is an example of a man who's a feminist and so on, especially given that her whole speech at the UN was about bringing men into feminism. I suppose that ties into it. So let me know your thoughts, and rest in peace, Alan Rickman. A quick point about his actual quote. He said, there's nothing wrong with men being feminists. Well, I would say I'd agree with that. There's nothing wrong with men being feminists, but I can't say I agree with his position because I'm not a feminist and I'm not going to pretend that I am. But I agree with the principle of it. I believe people have the right to describe themselves whatever way they want. So generally speaking, there's nothing wrong with men being feminists, but there is something wrong with men telling other men they should be feminists. That is wrong. Let me know your thoughts. Thanks for watching.